Why should we read Indian literature? Because we are Indian. We need to know our language, we need to know our culture, we need to know our history. And all of that is available in Indian literature and not in global literature. Hence, all the more reason why we need to read our literature. Hi. So Lopa asked me to recommend 5 novels from Indian literature, and I was very nervous in the beginning. I'm still nervous because 5 can never do justice to the large repertoire we have in Indian literature from 22 languages apart from English. But in my limited capacity, here are the 5 suggestions of Indian novels written in various languages. The first one is The Man from Chinnamasta, written by Indira Goswami, originally in Assamese, and it's a powerful novel. But before I go to the novel, I'm sure most of you know about the Kamakshi Temple or the Kamakhya Temple near Guwahati. It is one of the most important temples of Shakti worship. But we also, we might not know that it was also the place for a lot of fertility cult and tantric rituals of worship since the Middle Ages. And animal sacrifice formed a very significant part of these rituals. In the past, even humans were sacrificed. Indira Goswami was born in a district very close to Kamakshi Temple, and she had first-hand information about these rituals which were going on. Animal sacrifice is the center of this novel. The second one is a book that changed my life for good. Mother of 1084, Hadrat Rashid Ma by Mahashweta Devi, of course, originally written in Bangla. Hadrat Rashid Ma, even though written in the background, with the backdrop of Nazism, is basically a story of a mother whose revolutionary son has been imprisoned and condemned to death by the state powers. Now, the inner turmoil, the powerful tension in the protagonist's mind, the mother's mind, brought tears into my eyes. Because naturally, for a mother, the only victim is her son. The third book that I want you to try out is Samskara by U.R. Anantamurthy, originally written in Kannada. It is a heartbreaking novel narrating the physical relationship of a high caste man and a woman of a lower caste, which gives rise to a strong debate, a political debate about the caste system in southern India. But in an interview, U.R. Anantamurthy said, "I think my novel goes beyond the question of caste and gains an epic dimension. It becomes an allegorical tale. It has realism, but it is an allegory. In allegory, realism gets changed, but in realism, there is no place for allegory." The fourth book is called The Beasts of Burden by Imanam, and it was originally written in Tamil. Now, this is actually an autobiographical novel, a genre through which Dalit literature took India by storm. However, having said that, this was his first novel, Imanam's first novel, written at the age of 20. The original Tamil, Kovidu Kadu Thalgal, has been translated by none other than Lakshmi Holtzman. And she's one of the greatest translators I have ever read. This was his first novel, as I've mentioned. And expressing doubt about the popularity of Dalit autobiographies in a conference organized in April 2017, he said, "When academicians and media persons interview a writer, they ask them to comment on the role and function of literature and the writer's vision of life and literature. But in the case of a Dalit writer, questions are asked about their primary education, family, and the sufferings they have faced in their lives. This forces the Dalit writers to adopt the autobiographical mode of narration. He also mentions, the worst oppression of the caste system is that people are dependent upon for their living. Last but not the least, I have Sri Lal Shukla's Raag Darbari. Of course, I've read the original in Hindi. And of course, the English doesn't come any close to the Hindi original. But still, anybody who's not comfortable reading in Hindi must read this novel because it's a satirical take on the post-independent India and how it was during the time of during the years 1970s and 1980s. The plot is actually quite simple. An MA graduate in a city goes to his uncle in a village in order to regain his health after a taxing exam. During the course of his stays, he realizes, which happens to most urban Indians, that the villages, the picture in the villages is very different from what has been portrayed by the media and through different rhetorics and depictions. It is a brilliant novel, and especially the wit and the great humor that has been used makes the journey unforgettable. My list could go on and on and on. There are a lot of languages I haven't covered so far. So much to offer, and we haven't done justice by not reading them enough. Even if we read in translation, we must read these books.